you know a lot of things about Onkalo, but you don't know really how it feels to be there. So when you go down for the first time, you're quite excited. When even if it's only a tunnel, you know why the tunnel is excavated. So it's an interesting place.
The Onkalo tunnel will be the final resting place of Finland's nuclear waste for hundreds of thousands of years to come. 30% of Finland's energy comes from nuclear reactors like this one. Olkiluoto 3 is under construction, but when it's finished, it will be one of the world's largest nuclear reactors.
We will climb up quite high now, up to 19 meters, if it's okay with you.
I think that it's always better to put the used nuclear fuel down to the bedrock to 450 meters than where it is now in the temporary storages on the ground level.
Governments all over the world are trying to find long-term answers to the problems posed by nuclear waste. The Finnish solution is simple: to dig a hole 450 meters deep and place the fuel there.
How many meters is this until there's a kind of stop? There are like levels, it's not
yes,
open all the way.
135.
The fact is that the spent fuel is isolated with the bentonite buffer in the deposition holes. Thereafter, the whole tunnel is filled with bentonite clay. And then, approximately where is the cassette inside there in the tunnel, so there will be constructed a huge concrete, reinforced concrete block. So then, of course, in the real world, we have a 420 meters hard rock above it.
The bedrock provides conditions where changes are slow and predictable. Down here, the canisters are protected from any changes that might occur above ground, like a future ice age. In this demonstration tunnel, tests are currently being made to see how the Finnish rock react to the high heat that nuclear fuel will release.
As a geologist, I do trust the Finnish host rock, the Finnish bedrock, which age is like several thousand or million of years.
I try to tell people that radiation level goes down quite exponentially. People don't usually ask that. A lot of people do have the feeling that it's a time bomb or something for the millions of years, you know, that you are hiding it somewhere. Let's say 400, 500 years, the radiation level is so low that you could pick up this stuff and put it in the corner of your living room. That would be close to the natural level of radiation. But of course, the mice tail, or how can you call it, because the rain gets half, that's quite long. But then you don't talk really dangerous stuff anymore.